You know, sometimes I feel like Fannie Lou Hamer. I am just sick and tired of being sick and tired. And I'm just really tired of living around people who don't know how to live with other people. It's obvious. You know, I had to just go out and talk to my neighbor across the way. She just moved into the South Lawn area. And she got like a whole lot of little kids over there who are out unsupervised for the most part. I mean, little kids who need to be supervised. And, you know, they're messing with other people's stuff, their lawnmowers and their toys. You know, because here people leave out their toys for their children and all this kind of stuff. And so they're over there messing with other people's stuff. And I'm like, that is absolutely ridiculous, uncalled for. You know, common courtesy is to not mess with other people's things. And because these children were at this particular time supervised by some teenagers, one who was on the phone and one who was oblivious to what was going on. So, you know, my neighbor came out down the way and me and her were talking, and then another brother over the other way, you know, a Latino brother, we were talking. And you know, for the most part, people like to stand around and talk. You know what I'm saying? And observe and just talk about people and talk about how bad people are. But see, my thing is, why don't you just go over there and talk to the lady? You know, and tell her that this is what's going on. Because she's in the house. She ain't watching these kids. So I saw her come to the door. And when I saw her come to the door, I said, I'm going to talk to her. So I went over there and I told her what was going on. And, you know, for the most part, what I notice is when you bring to people's attention something that their children are doing, they automatically get defensive. I mean, that's the first stance that they take. But she complied and she called them all back to where they were supposed to be. And I noticed that from that point, they all stayed around the door where they live, which is where they're supposed to stay. You know what I'm saying? They're not supposed to be running all up and down the complex, all up and down the driveway. And people do flat through this driveway. And as soon as one of them get hit, they want to sue the city and sue the driver, when you should have been out there monitoring your children in the first place. Because first of all, they're too small to be all out in the driveway by themselves. So I did notice that she did comply, but I also noticed that she had an attitude. But like I told my neighbor down the way here, she's another woman who's single living here in this complex. And she complains a lot, but she basically calls management. I'm not a management caller type person. I like to go talk to the people first, you know what I'm saying? Establish a relationship with the people and talk to the people and see if we can get an understanding, you know. And like I was telling my neighbor next door, when I redirect your children, it is not because I'm being mean. It's because they are doing something that isn't, you know, productive for the community or me. You know what I'm saying? So if your child is out in front of my house playing ball and stepping on my flowers, then I got a problem with that. And I'm going to say something to them about that. And I did yesterday, I think it was. My little neighbor next door, him and his friend was playing ball. And you know those kids, they like to play soccer, particularly the Latino kids. They like to play soccer. And so I stood in my door because I knew that that ball was going to hit my flower. And lo and behold, the ball hit my flower. And I opened my door. I said, hey, you're going to kill my flowers? And so they stopped immediately playing ball, which is how their parents had them trained, okay? But I realized that grass is for people, kids to play on. And so what I did was I went in the house and I got a bucket. And I told the young boy, my neighbor here, I said, hey, put this bucket over my flower. And that way you and your friend can play without messing up my flower. And see, there's always room for compromise. You can always adjust. That's my point. But when you see children in danger, you have to step in and you have to step up. And that's what I saw earlier today with these little ones out here tumbling down hills on tricycles, which they could have hurt themselves, riding all out in the driveway, of which they could have got hit by a car or anything like that. Not only that, we live in such a dangerous society. Somebody could snatch up one of those little kids and be going on about their business. You know what I'm saying? I think it's just unconscionable that parents are so lackadaisical these days. So, you know, that's why I'm just kind of fed up. I'm just, like, tired. It just, I don't know. We need some kind of classes on how to live with other people. Because, you know, in this individualistic society, we don't know how to live with other people. We don't know how to share spaces and things like that. We think that, you know, what we do don't bother anyone else, like bouncing balls and all that kind of stuff. You know how a sound of a ball resonates? You know, and if you try to get some rest and somebody's under your bedroom window bouncing a ball, that's irritating. I know it irritates me. I don't know about you. But it irritates me. That's why they have a playground over there with a lot of concrete where you can bounce a ball all day long out of earshot of a whole lot of people and you don't have to disturb anyone. But see, I don't understand why people just don't take a walk and go do it. Or parents don't tell their children to go and do it. You know what I'm saying? Instead of waiting for someone to be disturbed, to have to step to them or report them to management, so that they can either get a warning or ticket or something that's going to come out of their pockets and cause them economic harm. You know what I'm saying? But sometimes you don't even have recourse. Sometimes you have to do that because people, you know, have an attitude and feel they can do whatever they want to do. But, you know, I'm in support of creating programs for people to learn how to live with other people. You know what I'm saying? Even though they give you a booklet of rules when you move into this complex, I could bet you a dime to a dollar that the majority of people have not read that book. And I could tell by riding through this community and seeing some of the things that I'm seeing. So, you know, I'm just venting right now because I'm pretty upset and frustrated. You know, when you see people just, you know, just doing stuff. I know some young people don't even live in this area. Congregating over here by other people's houses, sitting on stairs by other people's houses. I'm like, what are you doing here? You don't live over here. Go sit where you live. You know what I'm saying? I mean, a bunch of them hanging all off the banisters and stuff, white and black. You know what I mean? So, you know, you got to say something to them, and then you be the bitch of the neighborhood. I'm just going to get me a shirt that says bitch of the neighborhood, because I'm going to wear that badge and I'm going to make sure that, you know, things are like I want them or else I'm going to move. Simple as that. I don't want to move. I can't afford to move. But, you know, if I can't do nothing about stuff, I can't continue to live in frustration. I'm too old for that. I got to have some peace. You know what I'm saying? And so that's what I want to maintain. I want to maintain the quality of life that I'm accustomed to since I've been here, and I see it dwindling. So thank you for listening. I had to get this off to somebody. You know what I'm saying? And hopefully, I hope y'all pray for me. Pray to the ancestors or some of whoever you pray to give me some energy so that I can continue to fight this fight. Because I'm telling you, I believe that it's going to be a battle this summer. Straight up. So with that said, this is Queenie Fama. I am the Truth Terrorist, everyone. And again, thank you for listening and thank you for letting me vent to you today. Peace.